What's up? This video is about the direction where Netmarble is taking their game. Two things. One, Netmarble is just pulling shit out of their ass when they're making their in-game content or their competitive content. And they're going out of their way to make the in-game content completely unfair to the play. What do I mean by that? If we go to look at the boss battle, final boss battle, and it's not just in the final boss battle, it's in like the Tower of Trials, anything that's meant to be in-game content, even in the story content. This is what they're doing. This is their pattern. This is what they've been doing over the past few months or the past few releases. They're going out of the way to make the in-game competitive content unfair. Here's how. In phase one of this battle, Bond, he decreases damage taken from HP attribute minions by 50%. This is assumably on top of the type advantage that he already has. Increases the hero's damage dealt to HP attribute enemies by 300%. This is assumably on top of the type advantage he already has. Increases the damage dealt to demon enemies by 500%. So on top of everything else that he's already just been given, he now will do an additional 500% damage to demon enemies. This is ensuring that any demons you have in your roster that could work for this fight, they will now be made impotent. When HP reaches zero, uses three orbs to heal for 24% HP before death. Limit three times, activates for ultimate move gauge decrease. This is a more cheesy version of the one-time revival that has been plaguing a lot of their in-game NPC enemies. In this particular case, you have to kill Bond when he has less than three orbs in phase one. Or you have to attack Bond with the intent to defeat him when he has less than three orbs in phase one, or else he'll just simply revive, and he could do this three times. The reason why this is unfair is because the enemies, or Bond, he fills his ultimate move gauge fairly quickly. You know, in one turn, he could get like three or more orbs in one turn. Like, when it's not even so much even in a turn, when his skill cards are dealt to him, he could get like three or more orbs filled. Let's move on. Did I do this one? Increases lifesteal, blah, blah, blah. That's pretty normal, actually. Immune to attack disable and stat decrease effects. So things that you would do to help make the fight manageable, you can't do in this fight. Immune to freeze, petrify, and stun. So again, things you would normally try to do in this fight to make it more manageable, you can't do. This makes that it just makes it's like it can't be done. And then, you know, it just goes on to say what skills we use and so on and so on. Let's go ahead and look at Elaine. Increases allies' basic stats by 200% for each 200% for each hero in the battle with a commandment. Again, to make demon heroes impotent. Decrease the hero's damage taken from strength attribute enemies by 50%, which is assumably on top of the type advantage that she already has. Decreases allies' damage taken from enemy ranged attacks by 50%. You know, that's cheesy, that's unfair. Increases damage dealt to demon enemies by 500%, again, to make any demons impotent. Attacks while ignoring evasion. So this way she always steals orbs. Removes debuffs from the hero during the ally's turn. You can't stop her. You can't. There's nothing you can do to stop her from doing whatever she's going to do, outside of just simply defeating her. And there's a very similar thing in phase two. Applies an effect on the hero, which decreases their HP by 20% at the start of the battle for one turn. So this way, they make it unfair. So this way, you just can't one-shot her, which goes against the purpose of building ultra-powerful heroes. Decreases the hero's, defeats the purpose of building ultra-powerful heroes. such as the One, which they just released. Decreases the hero damage taken from HP attribute enemies by 50%. Increases the hero's damage to HP attribute enemies by 300%. Increases the damage dealt to enemies, to demon enemies by 500%. Increases damage dealt by 50% for every orb in the ultimate move gauge. This guy has 10 slots for its ultimate move gauge. So he can have up to 10 orbs. Extra 150% damage on top of what he's already doing. When HP reaches 0, 5 orbs are used to heal for 6% of HP before death limit 3 times. Extra base for ultimate move gauge decrease. It's the same as the first phase, but now he takes 5, which is essentially just half his bar. But it's still unfair, as you will come to see. And he heals for 6%, so he's come hard to kill. Not only that, increases the hero's defense by 50% of all enemies' defense. Immune to attack disable and stat decrease effects. Immune to freeze, petrify, and stun. Now here's why it's still like what I just described about his about when his HP reaches 0, 5 orbs used to heal for 6% HP limit 3 times is still unfair. Because when you go to Unlane, or actually it's in the description below, Bond revives by consuming fire orbs from his ultimate move gauge, increases damage dealt for every orb. Elaine decreases damage from melee attacks, decreasing her own ultimate move gauge to fill bonds. So it's like, as long as Elaine is alive, she will be giving orbs to Bond. Let's go to Elaine in phase 2. It's the same before with the commandment. It's the same before with the attribute type advantage. Decreases damage taken from ultimate moves by 30%. Decreases allies' damage taken from enemy melee attacks by 50%. Before in phase 1 it was ranged, but now it's melee. Increases damage dealt to demons by 500%. Attacks while ignoring evasion. Removes the abilities from the hero during the ally's turn. So on and so on. And in phase 1, what I forgot to mention is that Badon protects the lane by taunting enemies every 2 turns and directing all attacks his way, reviving like a smooth lures from his ultimate gauge. Elaine decreases damage from ranged attacks. I guess what I really wanted to say, I guess you have to look at his taunt skill. It's the fact that he taunts. This way you can't focus Elaine in phase 1. And when he taunts, when he uses that buff, he taunts enemies and increases HP by 60% for 2 turns. So this fight is unfair. Because unless you have a way, they created a fight where if you try to use heroes that can remove the buffs but are not speed attribute or let's say strength attribute, they will do more damage to them, ensuring that they get taken out very quickly. So they're forcing you to use a speed type hero because of all the extra damage they do to type advantage. You could try to use other heroes, but then they won't be as effective, or they won't have, let's say, the skills to nuke down one enemy. Or they will just be taking more damage from hits from Elaine, because the only other options that you may have might be a red hero or a strength hero. But that strength hero will take more damage from Elaine. So now that we've showed how they've just gone out of their way to give their enemy NPCs all these things to make them overpowered and to make other heroes in your roster impotent, to make the fight unfair, because this is the only way Netmarble knows how to balance out their in-game competitive content, is by simply making the in-game competitive content unfair. You know, that's the only answer to when you make such overpowered heroes. You can't, it's like, at least that's the only path they know how to follow. You know, you can't make a fight to where, let's say, it requires you to actually, let's say, pay attention on when you use those skills. Of those overpowered skills for your hero. They don't make fights like that. They just simply make the fights just flat out overpowered or unfair in favor of the NPC enemy. So this way they can steer you to whatever heroes they just released, which in this particular case, in this particular case, this is new banner right here, first 70th anniversary special draw. They put heroes in here that are designed for this fight, which is the Mono and the Valenti. And this is, let's say, proven when you come to the rankings and look at the top players. They're all using Valenti, at least Valenti, and in some cases, Mono. There's only one fighter here. Actually, okay, I'm incorrect in that. But they're using some variation of Valenti and Mono. There's only one player in here that I'm seeing not using any of them, but they are using the one Escanor. And that's this guy, whoever's in rank 5. He's not using either, not a Valenti or Mono. But all the top, well, most of the top players are using Valenti and Mono with the heroes they just came up with just for this release or just for this update with this final boss battle. This is where they're taking their end game competitive content. They're just simply making it unfair by making the enemies overpowered and making your hero roster impotent. So this way, they can steer you to the new heroes they just released for the update containing the end game competitive content. By making the game unfair that way, it's like a very big middle finger, a very big, like, fuck you to the players, because it completely disregards or shows no respect or any appreciation for the investment the players have made into the hero that they've already built thus far, whether that's investment of just time, effort, money, or all of the above. Because they just want to keep you invested in the game, so this way they can keep you as a potential customer. They don't really care about you as a player or how happy you are or how enjoyable you find the content. They only care so long as you're able to stick around, and hopefully they continue to keep you as a sheep for the fleecing. They could keep you spending. They could keep you spending your resources, in-game resources, real-world resources, and in this game, so this way they can have the potential to continue to make money off of it. Let me get away from this. So we don't have to keep listening to that. Now, the other thing that I want to talk about, or say number 2, is the skill card system. You know, at first, other people, I mean, I noticed this when I first started playing, or I saw this potential, others saw this potential. But I decided to go ahead and give the game a chance. The skill card system has shown itself to be rigged against the player. It has shown itself to be counterproductive to the level or to the level of play required for the in-game competitive content that they're making. What am I saying? The skill card system deals you cards at random after the first turn. In my observation, I have repeatedly noticed that when I go to fight an in-game competitive content battle for the first time or the first few times, using heroes that I've already built, which may not be the promoted heroes for this update, for this content, I would notice that I would be able to win because they still had good toolkits for the fight. Because I would be dealt the skill cards necessary in repeated turns. After that first turn or the first few turns, and if I win, or if it looks like I really had a good chance of winning, what I started noticing is that in the subsequent attempts of that in-game competitive content battle, I would start not getting the cards in the subsequent turns after the first turn when I'm making that attempt. I want to find a better way to be more concise, more to the point with that. What I'm saying is, in the first few attempts of in-game competitive content battle, I would get the skill cards necessary in order to beat that content. even when using heroes that are not promoted for that battle that were just released for that update for that content. After those first few attempts, any other attempts that I make, I will start noticing that I will stop getting their skill cards that had allowed me to beat it the first few times. And then that will continue to go on in all the other attempts that I make for like almost indefinitely. Until I start losing so poorly or so badly, or repeatedly losing so often, that then the game will decide, or the AI will decide to give me the skill cards again in order to allow me to win. That is so counterproductive to the level of skill level of play required in order to beat such unfair content. You need to have complete command control over your heroes and their skills and abilities in every turn in order to beat this unfair content. So when there's a skill card system with an AI that decides to not give you your skill cards necessary in order to win, and when you are playing at that high level, you notice this, you pay attention to this. And when you see this keeps happening repeatedly over all your attempts after the first few that you've made, until the AI decides to say after like 15 attempts of you just losing, to say, okay, here are the skill cards you need. And when you see that, wow, I just lost like 15 times in a row, but the moment I actually get the skill cards I need in these heroes toolkits, like I did the first few times, I'm able to win. You start realizing that the skill card system is rigged against you. It's rigged so the house always wins. And this is the direction that Netmarble is taking this game. They're making unfair in-game competitive battle content, and their skill card system is rigged against you so that way the house always wins. This is what Netmarble is doing. This is where the game is going. This is where it has been for the past few updates of in-game competitive content. Both, number one, the unfair advantage that the enemies have in their in-game competitive content, and number two, skill card system that is rigged against you to not give you the skills necessary to command your heroes to victory so that way the house always wins. It's a very demotivator to play this game long term and to invest heavily in this game, whether again time, effort, money, real world money, or all of the above. The fact that Netmarble is doing this, again, it's like a big middle finger, a big fuck you to the players. And it just shows how little they care for how happy the players are with their game and the content they're making and with how they're being treated. Just as long as they can continue to keep you invested in their game, and keep you as a potential paying real world money customer.